All right, let's add a check constraint to my table. Now, check constraints are handled a little funny. The problem is that MySQL doesn't actually handle check constraints. So you're going to create these check constraints, but MySQL is not really going to like it. The long story short, we want you to learn how to do check constraints because they're useful in other scenarios. So you just have to learn how to do this one by hand. All right, so we'll put a comment here so we can add my next one. Now, in this case, my check constraint is going to be I want to make sure that not only when they add their favorite number, not only is it not null, but that the favorite number has to be greater than zero. So I'm going to put this constraint in. I'm going to say constraint. I'm going to check. And then I'm simply going to say what I want to check, which is favorite number. What I want to do, I want to make sure that it's greater than zero. That's it. That's a check constraint. Now, the trick here is that when you take this and copy it and paste it into SQL, sometimes SQL will like it and sometimes it won't. So when it doesn't like it, you gotta hand check these things. All right, well, I can see here I need a comma there, so that fixes that. But if I look up here, I can see, no, everything looks good. My commas are in there. My constraint looks like it's written correctly. So I just have to go ahead and hit go and see if it runs. And sure enough, it runs. It doesn't give me any errors. So assuming I checked my work correctly, I know this is a good constraint, even though my MySQL doesn't know what to do with it. So that's how you do a check constraint.